Hi guys, it's Alex here with the Recombu, and I'm about to show you the new LG Optimus 4X HD. If you take it out of the box here. The 4X HD is actually LG's brand new flagship device. It's running Android Ice Cream Sandwich with a few LG tweaks and enhancements over the top, which I'll show you in a moment. As you can see on the front here, this is actually a 720p 4.7-inch true IPS HD display, so it's a really vibrant, bright, colourful display. It's actually really, really nice. And LG chose it because they say it also helps with power consumption. And as well on the front, to kind of reiterate the point, it's an ice cream sandwich device. You have three capacitive keys, a back, a home, and a menu key. And up the top here, we have a 1.3 megapixel front-facing camera for video calls and things like that. Looking around the device, it's a plastic feel with a textured back. It's actually really, really nice. One of the nicest LG handsets I think I've seen. Not too dissimilar from the LG Prada 3.0. that arrived last year. The handset actually features an 8 megapixel camera on the back with a single LED flash capable of 1080p HD video. On the top we have a standard headphone jack, a power and lock key, and a secondary microphone, probably for noise cancelling. Down the side here, you might not be able to see, but there's actually a diamond pattern, which is actually part of LG's prism design. It's a unique feature that they add to all of their premium handsets to kind of reiterate the point that they are the flagship, the top devices in their lineup. And in the middle of that prism design is a volume rocket integrated into the design, so it doesn't look too intrusive. It looks really nice. It's very nice between these two thin silver chrome strips. On this side we have nothing at all, just flush side, and on the bottom we have a micro USB port for charging, which also offers MHL support if you want to do video out to a TV or things like that. If I just take the back panel off, you might be able to see what this says here, which is NFC antenna. That means that this has NFC capability, so you'll be able to do things like Android Beam. You can tap on various devices and connect using Bluetooth for speakers and other accessories such as that support NFC. And there's also your SIM slot and also a micro SD card. The internal storage on the Optimus 4X HD is 16 gigabytes, but the expandable micro SD card takes it up to 32. So there's actually quite a lot of room for expansion there for your content. Now looking at the screen, I've turned the brightness down, but it supports up to 500 nits, which is the measurement of brightness on a display, which is pretty bright. LG have been known for producing really bright handsets, which means that they're really good for looking at in full sunlight and outdoor reading. And what they've done with the UI here is that they're using the latest version of their own custom overlay on Android Ice Cream Sandwich, which is called Optimus UI 3.0. Now what it does is it actually offers a lot of customizability, so if it's too intrusive you can turn it down, or if you really like it you can add more features as you see fit. So for instance, this carousel animation, which is called accordion, and you can see as the home screens fold up, if I go to the settings here, you can actually customize things like how the animation occurs between screens. So now this is called panorama, and it kind of does a swivel towards you as you pan across screens. Also, a really nice feature that LG have included on their applications is that any LG native apps that come with the phone, you can resize them from widgets down to app icons. And equally, you can do the same the other way around. So if you have the video player here, let's try it with the web browser. If I bring the web browser over here, so aside from just being an icon, if I tap and hold drag, it suddenly becomes your browser bookmark, so automatically you can jump straight to a web page you want. So it's a really, really nice kind of intuitive way of jumping between the two without having to jump to the widgets menu or the applications menu and pull them down independently. What's more, they've also included a few new features since the phone was announced at MWC in February, such as quick memo. So say I see something on the screen, at any point you can pull down the notifications panel, tap quick menu, and then you can customize your pen stylus. I'm going to go for a red broad felt tip here, and then you can highlight an element, or if you want to just draw a single note without anything behind it, you can just draw on a white note. There's some doodles from earlier, and then you can choose to save or share however you see fit. It's really nice if you just have an idea there and then, and you can just make it on the device without having to go to an extra application, and you can screen grab as you do so. You can even resize and crop out certain portions of the screen, so it's a really intuitive, simple little additional app. What's more, the NFC, they have also allowed you to create custom NFC settings, so you can tag an NFC capable device or accessory and tell the device to change settings or whatever you want. It's really, really flexible and really nice. One last thing I'd like to show you is the video player, which has got a couple of really unusual features that I haven't seen on another handset before. So say I'm playing a movie, So we've got a movie playing here. If you tap this button here, I can actually scroll back and forward and watch a small segment of the movie playing, so I can see where I'm going to jump to and see what's actually happening at that point in the movie, which is also really nice. And another feature is you can actually pinch to zoom and zoom around the video as it's playing, which is all capable thanks to the fact it has this quad-core processor. So that's the Optimus 4X HD. It's available now. You can get it for free on a £20.50 a month contract on 2 years from the likes of Phones4U, which is actually makes it one of the cheapest quad-core handsets out there right now. Thanks a lot.